Hello learners, welcome back for the new video. In this video we will design a mechanical flocculator for a flow of 300 meter cube per hour. So first we will see the design criteria for the design of mechanical flocculator. The depth of the tank should be in between 3 to 4.5 meter. Then the detention time for the flocculator is in between 10 to 40 minutes. Normal 13 minutes. Then velocity of flow, that is the horizontal velocity, is in between 0.2 to 0.8 meter per second, preferably 0.4 meter per second. Then total area of paddle, that is the total area of the paddle, the area required for the paddle should be in the range of 10 to 25% of the cross-sectional area. That means if suppose the cross-sectional area is 100 meter square, then the area of the paddle should be 10 to 25 meter square. So for we have to check for these values, that is the total area of paddle should be 10 to 25% of the cross-sectional area. Okay, then peripheral velocity of the blades. The blades which are present in the flocculator, or the flocculator consists of the blades or paddles or propellers. Okay, then the peripheral velocity of the blades means, suppose I will draw the plan of this, plan of the flocculator, and these are the blades associated, or these are the blades situated in the flocculator. So the peripheral velocity of the blade means, if the flocculator is rotating in this direction, clockwise direction, then the peripheral velocity means the velocity of the blade at this point. Okay, the velocity of blade at this point, at the tip of the blades. So this is the peripheral velocity of the blade, that is in between 0.2 to 0.6 meter per second. Then velocity gradient should be in the range of 10 to 75 per second. Velocity gradient means it is the rate of change of velocity with respect to distance. Okay, that means suppose the water is flowing from this point to this point, the velocity is gradually increasing or gradually decreasing. Velocity gradient means the rate of change of velocity from a particle to go from this point to this point with respect to this distance. Suppose this distance is 10 meter and the velocity is, suppose for example, velocity is 10 meter per second, that means the velocity gradient will be 10 meter per second divided by 10, that means 1 per second. This is the concept of velocity gradient. Okay, then GT factor, velocity gradient into time means detention time, it should be in the range of 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 5. Then power consumption should be in the range of 10 to 36 kilowatt per mld. That means for the treatment of 1 million liter of water in one day, the power consumption is in between 10 to 36 kilowatt. Then outlet flow velocity will be 0.15 to 0.25 meter per second. After the flocculation, the water which is going out of the flocculator, and that water should have the velocity in between 0.15 to 0.25 meter per second. So let's start with the actual design. We have to design a mechanical flocculator for a flow of 300 meter cube per hour. We know that Q is given, that is Q is equal to 300 meter cube per hour. Okay, we need the detention time of the flocculator is in meter cube per minute, in minute, that's why we have to convert it into meter cube per minute. 300 meter cube per minute divided by, that means 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So I will put this value as it is. Okay, then first here we have to assume the detention time or detention period. Detention time is in between 10 to 40 minutes. So I will take 20 minutes for the flocculation. We know that the formula for detention time is, detention time is equal to volume upon flow rate. वॉल्यूम इज इक्वल टू डिटेंशन टाइम टी डी इंटू फ्लो रेट. डिटेंशन टाइम इज 20 मिनट इंटू आई हैव कन्वर्टेड द मीटर क्यूब पर आवर इंटू मीटर क्यूब पर मिनट दैट इज 300/60 मीटर क्यूब पर मिनट. After calculating this, you will get 65,300 into 20, that is 100. Volume is 100 meter cube. The volume of the flocculator is 100 meter cube. We have find that the volume of the flocculator is 100 meter cube. Now we have to assume the third dimension or one dimension of the flocculator, that is the depth. Let's assume. Depth of the flocculator. Depth of the flocculator should be in between 3 to 4.5. I will take depth as 3 meter and 0.5 meter of freeboard. Okay. Then now we have the value of volume and depth. So let's find the area. Area is equal to volume upon depth. Volume is 100 meter cube. Depth is 3 meter. That means area is 33.33 meter square. Area of the flocculator is 33.33 meter square. Okay, then now we have to consider the tank as a rectangular or circular. Let's assume the tank is a rectangular. That's why we have to assume the L by B ratio. The tank is rectangular, that means the tank has length and breadth. And if the tank is circular, that means we have to simply calculate the diameter by the formula area is equal to pi by 4 d square. Here we have to find the two dimension, that's why I have to assume the ratio of L by B is 2. We'll take the ratio of L by B as 2, L is equal to 2b. We know that area is equal to length into breadth. Length is equal to 2b into b as 2b square. Area is 33.33 meter square, and after solving this you will get the value of b as 4.08 meter. Therefore length is the double of breadth 2b, that means 8.16. This is the length, breadth and height. We have find the length, breadth and height of the flocculator, but the flocculator tank also has a component, that is the blades or the paddles inside the flocculator. That's why we have to design for the number of blades or the number of paddles. Okay, so for rotating the blades or for rotating the paddles, the power is required. So first we will calculate the power. This power required can be given by mu v g square. Mu is the dynamic viscosity, v is the volume of the tank, and g is the velocity gradient. Okay, we know that value of mu is it is a standard value, 1.01 into 10 raised to minus 3 newton second per meter square. Volume we have calculated as 100 meter cube. Then velocity gradient, we have to assume the velocity gradient. Let's assume the velocity gradient g as 40 per second. So put these values in this equation. Let's find the power. Power is equal to mu v g square. Mu is 1.01 into 10 raised to minus 3 into volume is 100 into g value. Velocity gradient is 40 square, mu v g square. After calculating this, you will get the value of power as 161.6 watt remember that while writing the unit of power, if you are writing the complete word watt, in that case you have to write the W letter small, and if you are only writing the symbol, in that case you have to write the capital letter W. Okay, now this is the power which is required to rotate the flocculator. Then now we have to calculate the area of paddle or the number of paddle. For that we have to use the power formula, which is another for calculating the area of paddle we have to use the formula of power, that is power is equal to half CD into rho into AP into VRQ. What is that? CD is the drag coefficient and its value is in between 0.8 to 1.9. Then mu is the density of the water or the density of the fluid which is present in the flocculator. Then AP is the area of paddle and VR is the relative velocity. Relative velocity I will explain you later what is relative velocity. Okay, I will explain it right now. Okay, then relative velocity means, suppose this is a flocculator, the plan of the flocculator, and these are the centrally rotated, this is a shaft. Okay, if the shaft is rotating, the blades are also rotating, and these are the blades or paddles. Relative velocity means we know the VP. VP is the paddle velocity or the peripheral velocity of the blade. That means the at what velocity the paddle is rotating. Okay, and the what is relative velocity? When the paddle is if the paddle is rotating at some velocity, then the at what velocity the water which is nearer to the this paddle is rotating. That means the relative velocity is the velocity of the water which is closer to the paddle. Okay, and that velocity is called as the relative velocity, and that velocity is given by VR is equal to, it is 3/4 or 0.75 times the paddle velocity. Okay, it is 3/4 or 0.75 times the paddle velocity. Let's first assume paddle velocity or the peripheral velocity of the blade, that is in between 0.2 to 0.6 meter per second. So let's take 0.4 meter per second. Then VR is 0.75 into 0.4. That means the value is, after calculating, we will get the value as 0.3. meter per second. We have the value of relative velocity 0.3 meter per second. We know the density of water 1000. We know the value of CD, drag coefficient, it is in between 0.8 to 1.9. We have calculated power required by using formula mu v g square. Now we can calculate the area of the paddle. So let's put all this value in this equation. Power is 161.6, that is equal to half CD. Let's take the value of CD as 1.8 into density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube into area of paddle that we have to calculate. Then relative velocity is 0.3 cube. Here the only unknown is area of paddle, so the area of paddle will be equal to 6.64 meters square. Okay, here for calculating the area of paddle we have assumed lots of things. For calculating the power we have assumed lots of things. So let's take a check for the area of paddle, whether the assumed values are correct or not. So for that we have to take the ratio of area of paddle. Ratio of area of paddle to the area to the cross sectional area. Okay, and this value should be in between 10 to 25%. So let's take area of pedal upon cross sectional area. Area of pedal is 6.64 meter square. Cross sectional area we have already calculated it as 33.33. After calculating this, you will get the ratio as 0.1992, that means 19.92%. Okay, and it is in between 10 to 25%. Hence our design is okay. Our design is correct, or our assumptions are right. Then now we have calculated the area of pedal. Now we have to find the area of one pedal, or the dimensions of one pedal, or the number of pedals required for the flocculator. So let's assume the length of pedal here. We have to consider one thing while assuming length of pedal here. We have to consider one thing, whether the rotating shaft is parallel to the flow or the perpendicular to the flow. If, for example, let's take, if this is a tank and this is the suppose this is a pedal, okay, this is a flocculator and this is the pedal. So if the shaft is placed vertically to the vertically, that is the parallel to the depth, in that case you have to consider the length of the pedal should be less than the depth of the tank, because the length because the pedal should dip in the water, or the pedal should dip in the water, or pedal should not touch the base of the tank, or pedal should not exceed the water level. Okay, that's why while assuming the length of the pedal, we have to consider the length should be less than the depth. Suppose if I am considering the pedal, suppose if I am considering the shaft is parallel to the depth, so the length of the pedal should be the depth. The actual depth is 3 meter. Now I am providing clear space for the pedal as 0.3 meter from both side, from bottom and as well as on the top, that is 0.3, and that's why I have to multiply it by 2. So the length of pedal will be 2.4 meter. The length of pedal is 2.4 meter. Now assume the width of pedal. It is also assumed. Okay. Assume width of pedal is equal to, let's assume its value as 0.4 meter. Therefore, area of one pedal will be length into width. Length is 2.4 meter, width is 0.4 meter. You will get the area is 0.96 meter square, and we have the value of total area. Total area is 6.64 meter square. Now let's calculate the number of pedal. Number of pedal will be calculated as area of, this is the area of one pedal, okay, area of pedal divided by area of one pedal. Area of pedal is 6.64 meter square. Length is, area of one pedal is 0.96. After calculating this, you will get it as 6.91 numbers. As it is a number, so we have to round up it to the whole number, that is, let's assume it to 7, but the pedals should be in the pedal should be as a even number, so I will assume it to 8 number of pedal, so round up it to 8. Or you can consider if in case the number of pedals is 8.5, in that case you can also assume it to 9. In that case you don't need to assume it to 10, because if the number of pedals is 9, in that case you can have a configuration like, suppose this is the central shaft and this is the horizontal plate, and in this horizontal plate total number of pedals are 3 plus 3 6 plus 3 9. Here the number of pedals are 8, so we will have the configuration like, suppose this is the plan of the flocculator, this is the shaft, it is rotating, and we have two horizontal plates which is perpendicular to the shaft, which is mutually perpendicular. So here the number of pedals are 8, 2 plus 2 4 plus 2 6 plus 2 8. One more configuration can be possible. This is the central shaft, only one horizontal plate is there, so the number of pedals will be 1 2 3 4 on each side, 1 2 3 4. There are n number of configuration can be possible depending upon the number of pedals. So this is the design of the this is the design of the mechanical flocculator. Thank you.